Hey everyone, I'm Sumika Agarkar and welcome to Agarkar Media Academy. This is the second video, second tutorial in the Blender 2.81 tutorial series. In the last video, we saw how to install Blender, what Blender software is, what are the different workspaces inside of Blender and different windows inside of Blender. In this tutorial, we are going to look at the navigation in the 3D viewport itself. So let's get started. So basically, before we start the video, I just want to tell you, here I have started the screencast key. I don't remember the name of the software, but yeah, basically what happens here is whenever I press a key on the keyboard or on the mouse, you can see what I have clicked. So there will be many keyboard shortcuts that we are going to use in Blender. So for that, I have just started this screencast key software so that you can look at what are the keys that I'm pressing, right? So let's get into the video. Now we want to basically navigate inside of the 3D viewport. So this one here, this one is a 3D viewport. So whatever you see here is a 3D viewport. So navigation in the viewport is very, very, very simple. Basically, there are a few things that we want to look at. One is trackballing, so rotating the view from and looking at the models from all the sides. Then is the panning. Panning is basically when you have too much on one screen and you cannot fit everything in one screen, then you just move here and there. We'll be seeing what panning is, how it looks. And the third thing is scaling up or scaling down, zooming in or zooming out. So for trackballing, it is very easy. You just hold the middle mouse button and trackball and just move the mouse. You cannot see it here. As soon as I release the middle mouse button, you will see the middle mouse button, right? So I press the middle mouse button and I'm just moving the mouse up, down, rightwards, leftwards, right? So this is how you can trackball. You can rotate the view, right? Then is panning. So what we want to do is panning is there are too many stuffs in one screen and you cannot fit in one screen. You just want to move the scene, right? So what we do basically, press the shift button and the middle mouse button and move the mouse, right? Shift button, middle mouse button, move the mouse. So this is how panning is done. So you can see we are not rotating here, we are just going from left to right, right? So this is what, shift and middle mouse button for panning. And the other part is now zooming in and zooming out. So zooming in and zooming out is very, very, very simple. The middle mouse button, we don't want to click the button. We are just going to scroll up. Scrolling up, you can see in here on the screencast, scrolling up zooms in, scrolling down zooms out, scrolling up zooms in, scrolling down zooms out. So this is what, so we saw three functionalities here, trackballing, that is middle mouse button, shift and middle mouse button gives panning, and middle mouse scroll down is zoom out, middle mouse zoom in, scroll up, right? Now, if you don't have this middle mouse button and if you want to emulate the 3D mouse, the third button, then you just have to go to the edit, preferences, and in the input section we have this this one, emulate 3 button mouse. So I have turned it on for no reason basically, but if it by default it is turned off, you can just turn it on, and when you turn it on and just close the window, you can now click alt and right mouse button. So you can see left mouse button, alt and left mouse button for tracking. So the thing that was happening through the middle mouse button, just because you don't have the middle mouse button, now you can do it through alt and left click, right? The same goes for panning, alt, shift and left click, right? Alt, shift and left click, alt, shift and left click, right? Zooming in is a bit tricky. Basically, you have to do Control Alt and left click, right? Control Alt and left click. So Shift Alt and left click is panning, Alt and left click is trackballing, control and alt is zooming in and zooming out, right? So you just have to move the mouse up, move the mouse down, and you can zoom in and out. So these are different I don't like to use this functionality much, so I'm just going to turn it off again. I don't want to use emulation of 3D mouse, third button on the mouse. I already have a mouse with three buttons. So that's it in this video. We are going to look at other stuffs about the Blender 2.81, like adding the mesh and all that stuff in the next video. Till then, keep smiling and keep learning. And yeah, also, if you haven't yet subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do subscribe. Please share this video with your friends and family who can learn Blender and create awesome 3D animations in Blender. And that's it. If you have any comments, please do comment down in the comment section below. See you in the next video. Till then, keep smiling and keep learning.